there's so many mysteries out there in biology, and creating tools that give us a glimpse of biology in a new way, that leads in a very organic way to new discoveries. And I think that is the great hope for an institute like the Allen Institute for Cell Science. Doing that, however, creating those living functional tools is an enormous effort, and it has to be done very carefully, and it's the type of thing that's beyond an individual lab to do at a large scale.
I think that there's a great need for quantitative representations of cells and quantified data from images overall in the world. We see that in the Protein Atlas too. But I also think that people don't really know what they need yet. They don't know how to interpret those models and how to quantify the information from images, for example. So I think the fact that Allen Institute makes both the data sets and models available will really help people to make use and create biological insights from that data.
I think the tasks as a community that we are trying to solve as a community are daunting. They are not easy to be solved. And I think we have to kind of come together and solve them together. So sharing of data is important, because it is not a game to be played by a single group or even institute.
The Allen Institute for Cell Science, for me, is a place, it's really a mecca of cell biology for me, and for not just for me, for my entire group. And every time a publication comes out, every time a press release comes out of it, we're jumping on it, we're looking at it, we're teasing it apart and say, wow, next tool they have developed, let's use it. How do we integrate into the kind of the translational work we do? And they're focused on really basic fundamental roots of cell biology. And I think this is where the field should go.
Oh, well, look at this. I mean, you see, you have, so this is a 3D rendered image of RP cells that we, from iPS line that we got from Allen Institute. It's not known what is the localization of that each organelle. And I think these tools that we get from Allen Institute of Cell Science, I think it's enabling us to study that. You know, we know when a cell is mature, is functional, how that the lysosome organelle should be.
I think it's really important to have tools like Simularium and the other tools that are generated by the Allen Institute for our field, because we care a lot about making science that's reproducible. And in that sense, you want other people to be able to replicate exactly what you've done. And that means that the data needs to be shareable, and tools like Simularium, for example, make that possible.
One of the goals we had several years ago was to bring technologies that were cutting-edge technologies that we may not be able to have in the lab here, bring them to students. And I was looking for a good example of high-content microscopy, many, many cells screened or imaged, and I came across the Allen Institute and wonderful open data sets and a web portal that was useful and accessible to students and instructors. And it was a great way to include both the data as well as eventually the lesson plans.
Since I started my lab at the University of Washington about 2 years ago, I think tooling from the Allen Institute has permeated into just about every aspect of our lab's research. The tools and the protocols and the knowledge base that people at the Allen Institute for Cell Science have published and are willing to share and talk about have really lowered the barrier to entry for my students and for the rest of my lab, making it much more feasible that they can pick up these relatively complicated skills and have them work together so that we ourselves can have an interdisciplinary lab that combines modeling and experiments.
So I was very amazed that Paul Allen would do something like found an institute without profit in mind. And I think he was an example of sort of real altruism, a basic interest in science. All of us, you know, we come and go. Your legacy is what you've put down for the next generation. And he has really put something down very, very solid for the next generation. And I think has actually made a paradigm shift in aspects of stem cell biology. I don't think anybody else would have done this.
You know, a lot of people talk about open science and say they're doing open science, but the Allen Institute for Cell Science not only talks the open science talk, they walk the open science walk. And that's really unique in the field. By creating these tools, these technologies, these resources, these collections, that's something that nobody else can really do. And the way that you've combined expertise in so many key areas that are necessary to make these resources and these tools available, we are all better for having an Allen Institute for Cell Science because of that. You know, certainly nice if scientists have benefited from your resources. It's hard for me to think of anybody who hasn't benefited from these resources.
It jump-started my lab pretty much. I actually, here at the ISSCR, we have 10 people in total, so two talks and seven posters. And basically every single one of them is based on a variant of your cell lines.
My name is Jen Page. I am the stem cell co-director at the Salk Institute for Biological Studies. To be honest, I'm a little envious of the utility of the cell models that you generate and distribute, and I can only hope to make half as many useful cell lines as you have.
This is the coolest project I've ever been a part of, but it's also a bit nerve-wracking knowing that something you're working on for 3 to 4 years is going up on this single rocket. You hope everything goes well. But that's why you work with a great team of folks like the folks at the Allen Institute.
When many of us translational scientists who are at NIH who are trying to bring new technology, new treatment options to patients, we should not forget that everything is based on basic roots in cell biology. And that's what Allen Institute for Cell Sciences keeps reminding us and keeps making tools for us that we can keep utilizing into our translational work. And I hope people will more and more realize that and more utilize that. You can become a better translational scientist. You can bring better treatment options to patients if you understand the basic science of your cells at the most fundamental level in a better way.